So this is a Jackson Xstroyer. I've got a Dimaggio Super Distortion, and I play it on the Photograph, well, song, actually, when we do it with Def Leppard. On the original Pyromania recording, I used an Ibanez Destroyer, which had a Super Distortion pickup on it as well. So it kind of replicates that kind of vibe and everything. That's why I done it, because everyone always loves the sound of that solo. All the solos they've done on that album were actually with a Dimaggio Super Distortion. So here we go. I'm going to play along to the a live Def Leppard version. We're just taking the solo out. I've tried every other pickup out there, but I just keep going back to these ones, and just love how they sound. There's a purity, and it's great for me to express myself. Is actually the sound I hear in my head is actually this or a Super 3. So that's pretty cool. Okay, so this is the Xstroyer. This is awesome. It's this one's got a really fat neck on it, obviously. It sounds amazing. Obviously, Dimaggio's, that's a Super Distortion. That's the actual sustainer. On this particular one, I've got it so that I can actually, if it's on the bridge pickup, the sustainers work. But as soon as I flick it up there, they're non-active anymore. And this actually just works like a humbucker, and it's sweet. It's got a really kind of lovely sound. Obviously, the thickness in the wood is it's really fat and everything on the neck, and this is light. It's kind of like, you know, my old Destroyers were, I think they were made of basswood, some of them. I think this one is as well. That's a Floyd. We're talking about doing a signature Floyd. This is a titanium one. Obviously, it's all titanium, and obviously you can't see the block, but that's titanium as well. That's a kill switch because it's really cool. Eddie Van Halen had one. They said, you got to get one. So we did that. I played this for the first time at Rock and Rio last year. And then we made some adjustments. You know, we moved that out of the way. Joe at this, and Mike Shannon, they just cut some holes because everyone has their own preference. You know, I prefer it here so I can actually turn it down. And I'm using this thing all the time, so I can't have that in the way. This is a tone, that's a volume, and it's great. And that's a camera on there for anyone who's watching. When we do a Photograph, I use this for Photograph from Rock of Ages, you can see me doing this. And I hold it up and Vivian Campbell gets on the kill switch and does all the whammy bar stuff, and it comes up on the screen. So it's a nice little cool thing as well. But yeah, pretty awesome.
now, this is not going to be a cheap guitar because this is a very, very rare beast. This is not what most of you probably think it is. Most of you look at this and go, oh, that's a Phil Collen Ibanez Xstroyer. This is a different day because I have some extra information I wanted to give you and do a bit of a retake on something that I had before. So a lot of people think that this is a Phil Collen model guitar from Def Leppard. He used to use Ibanez Xstroyers back in the day, but it's actually not. Phil was playing the DT555, which came standard with a Stratocaster style bridge on it. If you watch, say, the photograph video, any of the stuff from the Pyromania era, and he was using guitars just like this, his had a Kayla tremolo system on it. His was actually retrofitted as such. It was not the original factory fit. They never released a model with a Kayla on it. And a lot of people, if you go looking on eBay and wherever, and you see that somebody's got one up with a Kayla, it is not an original factory fit. That's not how Ibanez ever made them. So that model, the DT555, this was the DG555, and was only ever made in 1986. The difference is that it has the original first ever edition of the Ibanez Edge tremolo system, precursor to what you knew as the Edge. The difference being that just here, it has this extra part that goes up a little bit higher on the guitar out of the bridge system, and they made it more flush later on from 1987 onwards. Some of the Maxis guitars actually still had that on them, but the majority of guitars that came out with this tremolo system on them ended up having the Edge that we know as from 1987 on the RG550s and so on. My guitar doesn't come with a hard case. It comes with the original padded leather gig bag, very 70s, 80s style there, that has the Ibanez logo there on the front, and that's exactly how it came brand new. This was an optional extra, as was the hard case, but most people here in Japan choose to buy soft cases for their instruments, not hard cases. Now let's get back into the video that I was doing before I started the whole extra take. Here it comes. I've done a little bit of research on a DG555. It seems like there's pretty limited numbers. The serial number it is on this one is D, meaning it was made in April. 86 for 1986, 0032. The neck on this thing is stunning. I mean, like, it's got a good, decent low action. I don't like my action to the point where it's like a hair off the fingerboard. There's no dead spots that I can recall on the instrument. Let's just go through it quickly. So I'll go the two humbuckers here. There's no dead notes on this guitar whatsoever. She's really, really nice. Let me put the clean sound on. It's very cool the way this thing switches. For now, just ignore the center pickup. We'll get back to that. I've got the center pickup turned off here. So master volume, center pickup, blend, tone pot. Twin humbuckers now. Neck humbucker. Now let's go through the blending in of the center pickup, because that's one of the cool things with this instrument, is the sound of doing this. I have the pickup, by the way, quite low, as you can see just here. You can see the heights of all of the pickups. Here we go with the sounds. This is going straight bridge humbucker, and then I'll blend in so you get these two together without the neck. Now we'll go twin humbuckers, then blend in so we get all three humbuckers together. And then go neck humbucker on its own. And blend in the neck and the middle together. Sweet sounds out of this guitar. The other thing is, with this instrument, there are no crackles or anything in any of the pots. All the pots run very smoothly on this instrument. Beautiful pots on there. So now I'll get you a distortion sound, which is Marshall-esque type of sound. Not a super, super high gain though. And here's what she sounds like straight bridge humbucker. Neck humbucker. Drop the volume pot down to get a cleaned up version. She's a killer guitar. Let's go high gain. Another cool thing with this instrument is the tremolo and the knife edges are totally cool. You can beat the hell out of this trem and she stays in tune. Here is what you can get out of pulling up the tremolo, because it's not actually recessed into the body here. So you only get basically a tone on the low strings. So that's the pullback. That's the only thing with this guitar, is if you're a serious pullback really far kind of a dude, you're not going to be too pleased with that. If you're the sort of person that likes to put your tremolo flush against the body, this guitar is actually pretty easy to do that with. You'll get extra resonance of the sound coming through the body, but I've never done it, and whoever else has owned it before me hasn't done it, because there's no ding marks here in underneath on the body where it's had that sort of pressure. It's obviously been floating its whole life. But that is the DG555 that I own. I'll be very sad to see her go, because I really do love this guitar. But as I've said, I'm working on a television show. I truly believe in it. When my TV show gets up and running, if I decide I would like to buy this guitar back, I will contact you. And to be honest with you, I will possibly even pay double what you are paying for the guitar. If you want to sell it, you'll sell it. If you don't, you won't. If I want it, I'll contact you. If I decide I'm just going to let it go. Anyway, this is a transaction for you purchasing. So if you want this guitar, she's all yours. Check the links and contact me through, whether it's Facebook, Reverb, Instagram, wherever you happen to see this guitar. There should be pricing on there, because I haven't decided what price I'm going to put on it yet. There's no serious chips anywhere on the end here. There's a little bit of a mark up there. But generally, all in all, she's in pretty good nick. There are two little chips just here and here. But other than that, she's pretty sweet. I'll show you on the second camera there, even though it's not focused properly, you can at least see it. But the rest of the spots are all cool. She's a very sweet instrument, this guitar. I'm going to be sad to see her go. She's a beauty.